Today we're going to look at what a DAQ is and how you can use one to make quick temperature measurements. Hi, I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to take a quick look at how to make temperature measurements with a data acquisition system, also known as a DAQ. A DAQ system is a general measurement system, and they can measure temperature and some electrical parameters like voltage, current, resistance, capacitance, and more. They may or may not have a built-in source and a built-in DMM to make these measurements easier. If a DAQ does have a source, it's generally a low-power source for basic measurement requirements. So in many DAQ setups, you'll need to complement the system by including DC power supplies, arbitrary waveform generators, or RF and microwave signal generators. These allow you to provide DC biasing or test signals to your device under test. Today though, we're gonna keep it simple and use just a DAQ to measure a few thermistors on my temperature cube and see how the fan impacts the system temperature. This is a pretty common test that you might have to run on your devices. We're using a DAQ970A and a DAQ M901A multiplexer module. The DAQ is wired to the temperature cube and can measure the temperature with its built-in thermistor temperature sensors. We're also using a USB cable to connect the DAQ to my laptop and using the BenchView DAQ software to control it. We're just using a basic temperature cube, but a setup similar to this gets used all the time in the wild. This type of setup could be used to measure more than just temperature. DAQs can measure all kinds of electrical characteristics and are often used to test things like AC to DC power converters, battery packs, medical devices, and radio communication devices. So there are three main steps to making a temperature measurement. First, we need to connect and configure our setup. In this case, we're gonna use the DAQ-M901A modules channels 101, 102, and 103, which are wired to the temperature cube's thermistors T1, T2, and T3. Then we're gonna open up BenchView and make sure we're connected and ready to configure our DAQ. With a modern DAQ, you can set up, collect, and analyze data in a single piece of software. Now that it's connected, we'll go to step two, setting up our test. In BenchView, I'm gonna set up the temperature channels in an easy spreadsheet format. We're using 10 kiloohm thermistors, so I'm gonna set each channel to the appropriate setting. Now that we're set up, we can run it. I'm gonna hit start in BenchView, and I'm gonna switch over to my graphics setup so I can watch it running. We can hear my relays clicking, and I'm gonna turn my system on. And we'll be able to see the temperature start to rise as my system runs without any fan. And we're gonna give it a second and turn on the fan and see what happens. Since our graph has gone off screen, I'm gonna go ahead and auto scale in BenchView, and I'm gonna turn on my system's fan. And we should now see the temperature start to drop. And you can see the fans had a pretty big impact on our temperature, so for today's purposes, that is plenty of information for us. Once we've run our tests, we can move to step three, exporting and analyzing data. I'd like to get it in Excel format, but you can also see that BenchView is providing some basic analysis for me. So I want to do some post-process analysis in Excel, so I'm going to hit Export All. And you can see it gives me a couple file options. We're going to choose Excel and Export here. And it's going to automatically save that to an Excel file and open that up in the Explorer. And when I go to open this up, you can see it has all of my test information here. And when I scroll down, I have all of my data. I should point out that DAQs generally have a memory limit when running tests. This one can store 100K readings into its internal non-volatile memory, meaning you can power cycle it and not lose your readings. But when connected to BenchView, it can use the PC's memory to store up to 1 million readings. So those are the three main steps to making measurements with a DAQ. Connect everything together, set up your test procedure, and analyze your data. In this case, we looked at a simple temperature measurement to see what impact our fan had in our system, but like I said, DAQs can measure so much more. They can be used to monitor and optimize battery consumption, they can be used to monitor power converters, monitor efficiency of solar power panels, and it can even be used to perform fatigue testing of mechanical components with strain measurement capabilities. And it can perform overvoltage and overcurrent measurements with built-in alarm triggers, so you can trigger alerts if something goes wrong. For more about DAQs, check out the free ebook, 4 Things to Consider When Using a DAQ as a Data Logger. There's a link for that in the description. How are you using DAQs in your test setup? Let us know in the comments. Make sure to like and subscribe, and check out the description for more info on the DAQ 970A and BenchView. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.